Good morning, everybody. This is K. Balakrishna. Presently, we are dealing with the subject financial services. In the financial services, we are dealing with the topic called as merchant bankers. Merchant bankers are the organizations that provide large number of services like corporate counseling, corporate advisory, project counseling, project advisory, portfolio management, underwriting, and many other services apart. Who are called as merchant bankers? Merchant bankers are the organizations that perform large number of services like project counseling, advisory, corporate counseling, advisory services, apart from this, portfolio management services, apart from this, corporate restructuring services, and many other services they are rendered by the merchant bankers. In many companies, merchant banking and investment banking, in many countries, merchant banking and investment banking is same. But in India, there is one difference. There are many differences between merchant banking and investment banking. Investment banking provides only advisory services regarding the funds to be raised, whereas merchant banking provides large number of services apart from investment services. What do you mean by merchant bankers? Merchant bankers are the organizations that provides large number of services apart from underwriting services. What do you mean by underwriting services? It underwrites the securities. What do you mean by underwriting services? They will give the assurance to the companies that they will purchase the remaining shares left out after a public issue. What are the functions of merchant bankers? First one is they see whether the projects are good or bad. They can clearly say that whether the project can be accepted or not. They advise the companies whether to go for expansion or not, whether to participate in the mergers, acquisitions or not. They provide underwriting services, that is, they first give the assurance that they will purchase the shares left out after a public issue. They can act as collectors, in the sense they can act as a bankers to the issue. That is, all the transactions of the issue will be monitored by the merchant bankers. They can refund the banker, in the sense they can act as a bank refundant. In the sense, if the issue is oversubscribed, the money is refunded back to the investors. So, it's a monitoring agency. Merchant bankers are called as the most important supervising agencies, nowadays. Next, debenture trustees. Debenture trustees mean they act as trustees. They are taken into belief for the investors and then they are invested. Next one is categories of merchant banker. There are four major categories or types of merchant bankers. There are four major categories or types of merchant bankers. Category four says that they can act. Category four says that they can act only as the advisors or consultants. Category four says that they can act as only the advisors or consultants. Similarly, category three says that they can act as underwriters, advisors, as well as consultants. Category two managers can act as advisors and consultants, underwriters, and portfolio managers also. Category one can act as advisors, consultants, co-managers, underwriters, portfolio managers, as well as issue management services also. What is the capital adequacy norm for the merchant bankers? If it is from 0 to 20 lakhs, they can be nominated as category 4 managers. If it is 20 to 50 lakhs, they can be nominated as category 3 managers. If it is from 50 to 5 crore, they can be categorized as category 2 managers. If it is above 5 crore or above, they can be categorized as category 1 managers. What are the services rendered by the merchant bankers? There are a large number of services rendered by the merchant bankers like the following. First and foremost, the service is corporate counseling services. They provide advices to the companies whether to go for expansion or not, whether to go for mergers or not. Project counseling, they give the advices to the companies whether they can go for accepting the project or rejecting the project. If they cannot get the loan from a single bank, this merchant bankers help in getting a loan from syndicate of banks. Next one, they can also act as a management of capital issues. Capital issues in the sense they help the organizations to take long-term decisions pertaining to mergers and acquisitions, takeovers, joint ventures, or many others also. They help in reviving the sickness or restructuring or take over of the sickness. Next one is they also provide advisory services. They suggest the companies in many areas. Next, they design the portfolio, they revise the portfolio, they construct the portfolio for the companies. They also help in leasing services. Next, they also perform all the details right from pre-issue management services to issue of prospectus to post-issue management like allotment of securities and many others. What are the principal steps involved in the issue of prospectus? First and the foremost step involved is designing the prospectus. The next one is they will price the issue, whether they go for fixed price or whether they go for which building is being used. Next, they also give the information who are the underwriters, how much to underwrite. Next one, they also provide an appointment to the bankers, who can act as banker to the issue and who precede the issue and other things. They can also appoint the registrars. This merchant bankers can also appoint the registrars of the issue, ROCs. Next, they can appoint the brokers and help in subscribing the capital. Qualities of merchant bankers. First and foremost, quality of merchant banker is they should know the information. That is, they must have certain knowledge and information regarding the issue management services, regarding the capital markets and other things. They have to analyze and evaluate the situations faced by the corporate enterprises. They have to provide the services based on technical, financial, and economic analysis conducted on the company. Next, their primary responsibility to protect the rights of the investors. SEBI guidelines for the merchant banker. The main guideline for the merchant SEBI is, since the environment is complex, dynamic, the merchant bankers must be careful in analyzing the capital market trends and keep in relationship with the investors. They have to see all the capital market instruments. What are all the capital market instruments? Equity shares, preferential shares, debentures, bonds, etc. can be called as capital market financial instruments. They must restrict or concentrate and develop the mechanisms so as to minimize the cost structures of the company. As per the SEBI guidelines, merchant bankers have to can authorize the entire issue management activities. They not only can suggest the companies, but they can also provide all sorts of issue management services apart from preparation of prospectus to the allotment of shares. Next, just like underwriters, they also have a capital adequacy norm, and the capital adequacy norm has already been discussed in the account, that is from 0 to 20 lakhs category 1, 20 to 50 second category, 50 to 5 crore third category, 5 crore and above, it is fourth category of merchant bankers. So next one is the issuing companies must also consider this capital adequacy at the time of allotment. Next one is if the merchant banking activities is very vast, but they have to develop an adequate expertise, or otherwise they cannot survive in this competitive environment. Next one is who can be appointed as a merchant banker? There are a large number of people who can be acted as a merchant banker. First and foremost is they must be qualified in finance, law, or business. They must have adequate office space, equipment, and manpower. And they must have at least two people who have qualified expertise. Next one is there must be no discrimination shown in any of the transaction risks with any company. They have to operate under SEBI regarding supervising of all the activities. What's the future prospects of merchant banking in India? Since the primary markets are going, the necessity of merchant banking has increased rapidly. And since the number of companies going for the public issue has been tremendously increasing, the primary market demand has been increased and growth of the primary market has been transcended. This large number of foreign investors are entering into the markets. They do not know about the domestic market rules and regulations. It is only the merchant bankers who can help them. Next, there is also a changing policy of institutions which need to be kept in mind while going for merchant banking activities. Merchant banking are important for the SIC units because they can advise the SIC unit how to come out of losses. They have two plans, whether it is to go for a takeover or whether to dissolve the company. Dissolve the company is the last issue. Taking over the company means there requires a huge amount of analysis to be done. In this class, we have discussed various issues pertaining to the merchant bankers. Right from SEBI guidelines, future prospects, apart from this, we also discussed the capital adequacy norms. We also discussed the types of merchant bankers and many other issues. Thank you.